It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and Pepper, Heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, Rapper Pack, Mr. Magic, Molly Mall. Huh? It is truly my honor to be here in Worcester today to be with the Massachusetts GOP. This U.S. Senate race this year has brought out a diverse group of people that want to better Massachusetts for better Massachusetts for all residents. Yesterday, as I was going to work, riding on the back of a Republic trash truck, I thought to myself, what would I say to the convention? I wanted to make an impact. See, honestly, I thought that the crowd would be a lot older and less diverse, but I'm very surprised today. There are a lot of young people and a lot of diversity today. And it's an honor to be here amongst all you people who want to make the country better. And the first way we make our country better is sending Elizabeth Warren home November 6th. The first thing I wanted to talk about is the number 139. The number 139 is the number of unopposed state representatives, state senators, and congressmen in Massachusetts in 2016. In cities like Lynn, in Brockton, Lowell, Boston, they have not had a Republican candidate on the ballot since 2014. Today, you delegates have an awesome responsibility where you can change that situation. I keep hearing that Massachusetts is a blue state, but every time I look at the voter rolls, it looks like the unenrolled are the majority, not the Democrats. See, I could have lost faith in the Mass GOP and went independent like the other minority candidates in this race. But like Frederick Douglass said, I am a black Republican, dyed in the wool of Republican. I never intended to belong to Kanye West this week, where Kanye West said that he had love. He don't agree with everything the president says, but he has love for the president of the United States. I want to ask delegates today, when did showing love to the president of the United States become a crime? A few days ago, I was in Lynn. Lynn, woo, where's Lynn at? The other day I was in Lynn for a Frederick Douglass event. Frederick Douglass turned 200 years old this year. And many might not know, but Frederick Douglass got his start in Massachusetts. In 1838, Frederick as a runaway slave ended up in New Bedford, Massachusetts. There's New Bedford in the house! And Frederick Douglass was taken in by a family named Ron and Polly Johnson. And there he began to build his life as a freedman and as one of the greatest Americans in our history. Frederick Douglass didn't have many skills, but as a slave, he learned how to cart ships. So he got a job at the New Bedford New Bedford shipyard as a pauper. And he began speaking about ending slavery around the country. And what I didn't know is Frederick Douglass lived in Lynn. And he actually became Frederick Douglass in Lynn. And those cities like Lynn, Brockton, New Bedford, Lowell, Lawrence, Springfield, Worcester, where we stand today, are great cities. And the mass GOP needs to compete for those votes. It's not right for the voters of these great cities. It's not right for the voters of these great urban, gateway, industrial cities to go to the ballots on election day and look and only see a Democrat on the ballot. What's up with that? Republicans can't win in some parts of Massachusetts. False. Republicans can win any place Democrats can win. Mark my words on it. And if you get me on the ballot today, we're going to show them in November when we send Elizabeth Warren home in the biggest U.S. Senate upset in history. In 1858, President Lincoln had himself a U.S. Senate race. He challenged a senator who thought he already had his re-election ready, and he was ready to run for president, Stephen Douglas. Does that sound familiar? This year, Lincoln lost that race. But what Lincoln did in that race is he set course for the future of our country. Lincoln stood on principle. Lincoln wasn't about raising millions of dollars. Lincoln was about standing up for something, having a backbone, believing in our country, and standing up for the underprivileged. I think it's time to get a new senator in Massachusetts because Senator Warren is just so divisive. When I hear Senator Warren talk, I think of an old Bee Gees song. It's called Jive Talk. And the fight that African Americans have are intertwined. I don't think so, Senator Warren. I don't know many African Americans who raise $250,000 a week. Senator Warren says she fights for the underdog. But in 2016, when we were trying to pass a charter school extension so poor kids can have choice for education, even though Elizabeth Warren agreed with charter schools, she sided with the unions. That doesn't sound like siding with underdogs to me. And they were tied up in Massachusetts. Did Elizabeth Warren come out and...
Nine-minute mark.
Let me finish, please, sir. But no, in all fairness, though, Senator Warren said she stood up for the underdog, but she came out against Tito Jackson in 2017 to go for Marty Walsh, who had raised millions of more dollars than Tito Jackson. But Senator Warren still supports the big guy. Senator Warren does not support the little guy. The little guy is here today. And you guys, if you nominate me, you will get a candidate that will fight in all 350 towns. And with God's help, Let me finish in closing. Sorry, in closing, don't listen to the media. We can send Senator Warren packing with God's help, because God helped Joshua in the battle with Jericho. He helped Daniel out of the lion's den. He helped Gilead.